Oh, well, guys, it's December 8th, 2011. I'm back out here in the shop. It's kind of late at night. I had a tough day today. I posted a video, a couple videos, I think, on CCing this particular head here. Had not done any head work to it, and the valves were still in place. And I thought before I took the valves out, I would CC the chamber volume to see, to get a rough idea what kind of volume I was dealing with on each of these chambers. And so that all was done, and I flipped it over and started to remove the valves out of the engine. You can see I got all the keepers and everything, and the valves, valve springs and all that over there. But here's what I found on this head, which I thought were ready to go on an engine. I bought them that way, and you know, the guy said, yeah, these are already done. So, you know, they had installed, you know, new valves and new springs and everything, but I'm hoping you can get a good look. Here's one that is close. I don't have to shift the camera too much. I count five of these valve stem bosses cracked. Let me see if I can get you guys in on this one right there. I don't know how well that's coming out, but you can see a crack right there, and that's on the number. That's on the, all right, now I'm not even sure what cylinder this is on, but let's see if I can get, there's another crack right there. So that's a crack in that one, a crack in that one, the next one down, big old crack in that one. I think this one looks pretty good. So anyway, that's three. There's another one there. That's four. And then the last one is right there. That's a crack right there. That's five. Five out of eight. So my guess is they put the wrong, I don't know, I'm guessing that they put the wrong size valve stem guys, or did not drill the holes out wide enough. Too much of an interference fit on these as they pressed them in. I have no idea, but five of them are cracked. On an otherwise fairly nice head, but basically this head is a boat anchor. So luckily I had not gotten to do any of the flash or deburring on this head, or any of the port matching or anything like that I intended to do with this. Only thing I did with it was CC it. Took it out of the bag. I got it in and put it up on the bench and started working on it. So these are 6X, and you can see that, but that's the 8. And so I'll be looking for another one of those. I have a lead on a couple, but I'm going to call the guy that I bought these heads from. I did not buy these on eBay, where it was like a, you know, as is where is kind of thing. I should have some recourse, at least on this one head. So that is, if anything else, just one reason why you really need to go through the engine. You really need to go double check everything. Guy tells you, somebody tells you everything is good. Say thank you very much, and then do your own work on it, because you never know. You never know. If I had put these in there, they would, at least for a while, run like crap. But if these broke off completely, I'm sure I would have dropped the valve, and then it's a complete rebuild and probably a new block. So that's it, lesson learned. I'm kind of stalled on the heads for now, so there won't be any videos on those for a while. I'll probably post a video when I get the new head. With the other one seems good. I'm gonna give it another once over before I take it to the machine shop. And actually, all of this would have been saved had I taken it to the machine shop initially and had a Magnaflux everything. They would have seen that right away. I wanted to get started on the block first, and I hadn't really touched anything on these heads. But it is what it is. So found out about it now, luckily, before I put it in the engine. So that's it for now. Just a short video on this. We're at about 6 minutes here. But short video. I'll make another one as soon as I get another head. Stay tuned.